This episode of D News is brought to you by Audible. They just talk all the time. It's maddening. I'm trying to watch TV, and they just start gabbing and chattering. Does this sound familiar? Well, it's your fault. Hey, ladies and gentlemen, Trace here for D News with some more interesting science for you. Listening to that introduction, did you think I was talking about a woman or a man? To be honest, the answer doesn't really matter. The stereotype is real. The stereotype is that women talk more. They're chatty Cathys or gossip girls or Miss Chatterboxes. But science says that this stereotype is not true. And yet, when researchers found the answer, it kind of makes you go, oh. Makes sense. Who talks more has been studied for years by scientists, and from various angles. Scientists have looked at the number of words used per day, time spent talking, who takes more turns talking, and even whether one group is better at talking. Dozens of different studies have tried to answer this silly stereotype, who talks more and why, and it turns out that by most measures, men and women talk the same amount. In 2004, the American Psychological Association took the results of 73 different studies of children and found that boys and girls talk about the same, though girls language skills tended to develop more quickly. In 2007, the University of Texas at Austin found that both men and women in the US and Mexico use an average of about 16,000 words per day, while another study from the University of California found that men talk just a little bit more. And in 2008, a study in neuropsychology found that the brains of girls process words better than the brains of boys, and now a 2014 study took the research to a whole new level by adding the element of context. Boom! Mind blown, right? Of course. Where you are is going to change what you talk about and how much you have to say. Right now, at this moment, I am probably talking more than you, but that doesn't mean that I'm more chatty overall, though I do talk a lot. The study, published in Scientific Reports, gave two groups of people sociometers, which are wearable cell phone-sized devices that can measure real-time social interaction and data. One group was master's students and the others were workers at a call center. Both were split male and female. The group of master's students were asked to grade a project in 12 hours, and they talked a lot, while the group at the call center were in a lunchroom on a break and thus only talked a little. For the master's students, women tended to have longer conversations with other women, but overall, communication was similar. And in the lunchroom, it was virtually equal in all respects. And you can break this down even further if you want. In groups of less than six people, the female master's students talked more. But in groups of more than six, the males talked more. But when there were no groups at all built by the participants, there was, quote, no detectable difference in talkativeness between men and women. Perhaps this indicates some kind of bias in the way we structure our group communication? More research is needed there, but can we please put to rest women talk all the time crap? Because it's obviously not true. Now, if you're mad because your friend is talking during the big game or the new girl or Orange is the New Black, that's different. That's just your friend and you having to deal with some things. So who does most of the gabbing in your social group? The guys or the ladies? Tell us below in the comments and subscribe for more D News. If you're like me and you love listening to people talk, check out Audible. They have hundreds of thousands of audiobooks like Under the Dome by Stephen King. I have been addicted to this book all weekend. It's all I'm consuming right now. You can check out Under the Dome or a different book for free on Audible. Your first book is free. Just go to audible.com/dnews to sign up. You support us and you get to listen to your favorite books. See y'all later and thanks for tuning in.